Good evening, everyone, and welcome to yet another episode of the FPV Livestream. This week brought to you by our wonderful sponsor, FPVHQ. If you haven't heard about these guys yet, it's because they are or were Multi-Rotor Superstore, kind of now rebranded into all things FPV, not just mini quads or just fixed wing, but both. And they sell products ranging from wings to quads to starter kits to everything that you could possibly imagine for first-person view stuff. And as a result of their new grand opening, we decided to work together to build a wing. I've never done this before. I'm going to go ahead and just lead with that. I have no idea what I'm doing. So if you are an experienced foamy builder or wing builder or something, and you see me doing something stupid, I probably am. So if you have the presence of mind to say, hold on, no, wait, you're an idiot, go ahead and say that. This is your opportunity to do so. The second thing that I want to go over is thanks to everybody for stopping by. If you're a first-time visitor, it's great to have you. We do this every week on Thursdays around 8 o'clock Eastern. Then if you're a returning guest, thanks for sticking with me through mini quads. Now we're going to try out something a little bit different. I hope that you enjoy the change of pace. This episode will probably be a little bit slower than some others. We won't have any, we're actually not going to do any electronics tonight. It's all going to be fiddling with foam. So I'm not sure how that's going to go. If you guys hate it, let me know. If you guys love it, we'll do something else like it. And finally, if you're a vendor, I would love to partner with you to do more episodes like this. So I'm going to kick it off with a giveaway, actually. And the way I'm going to do that is... how do I want to do that? I know. Okay. So, this week's giveaway is going to be done via Instagram. No, it's going to be done via Facebook. All right, so on Facebook, there is a page called TheFPV Livestream. There's a link to it in the description here. You're going to go leave a comment on a post that I'm going to make. Let's see. I'm going to go over there right now and do that. I'll show you what the product is. We're going to go to the FPV live stream. This week's giveaway. Oh, scheiße. Get out of the way. Is the Gorilla Quads 24x19 mat in your color, your choice of color? Gorilla Quads. Oh, it's 25x19. There we go. All right, so everyone that's here, if you want to enter the giveaway, you have to comment, go there, comment on that post, and you have the chance to win one of these. Comment with the color that you want to get. I posted a link to the site, so you can see exactly what is offered, but right here is the mat. This is what we've been working with for a couple weeks now. They were very generous and sent one of these over to be used on the live stream every week. And now one of these could be yours if you win the giveaway. So go there, like the FPV live stream on Facebook, and comment with your favorite color, or with the color you want to win. Okay, now, forget all that. Back to FPVHQ. Okay, so the first thing I want to do is go over the gear that we're going with here. So FPVHQ has released a flying wing kit. Now what that means is that they are going to give you literally everything you need to get your foam off the ground into the air and flying around. That doesn't include FPV stuff, but you know, that's kind of, that kind of ends up being dealer's choice. You get to go ahead and decide for yourself which ones you want to list, or what kind of FPV electronics you want to put on there. So you have to bring your own electronics, but you get to you get everything else you need to get this thing in the air. So this is the foam that comes with the kit. I have already painted this because I didn't want you guys to have to sit here literally watching paint dry. So I literally just, this is just spray paint from Lowe's, actually Home Depot. And I just taped off the edges so I could get some little nice wing tips here. And then these are going to be the elevons, which are the control surfaces of this thing. And they're going to be green. So you can kind of get a sense of how it's going to turn out. I kind of have a thing for green with green highlights. The all of the electronics will kind of be buried in the foam up here. So I have no idea what I'm doing. I actually literally printed out the instructions so that we can go over them together. Because like I said, I have no idea what I'm doing. This could be the worst episode ever. We could like melt some foam or do something stupid. So get excited. We'll see what happens. All right, let's set this aside for now. It comes with a Tattoo 3-cell 45C battery. You're not going to need more than 45C. You probably don't even need much more than like 20. Good quality battery for that. We've got, for motors, you have the, what was this called? It's like the McFly or the Fly something. FPVHQ.co. Let me double check this real quick. Make sure I get it exactly right. I saw the motor name and I forgot it already because I'm a stupid head. It is called a Angry Bees 2204 2450 kV. So it's almost 2500 kV. Just a little motor. I think this is probably based on the Airbots. Yeah, I have a bunch of these for mini quads, 2206, 2200 kVs. Really like them, so I'm excited to see what this will do on the plane. Because high kV with a 3-cell is going to do some fun stuff. Next, you get some Emax Metal Gear servos. These are going to obviously move the control surfaces for you. They if you've never worked with a servo before, like I hadn't until fairly recently, you want to have a metal gear because otherwise the gears inside there can strip, and it comes with different mounting mechanisms and throw arms and stuff like that. So that's what this is. Then you also get a second one. Mine came with an X4R, not Dash SB, because we're not going to be running this on S-Bus because it's... because there's no flight controller, so it's just going to be running on PWM anyway, so you might as well take the older model. So that's good. You get this giant, fat speed controller, and the reason you get the really big one is because this also has a 2-amp BEC, or step-down regulator, for the servos, which can draw a lot of power. So you need a big 5-volt BEC. They sent along some props. I don't know if that's normal. These are 4045. And then there's the miscellaneous things that you need to build with. So let me pull these out. This is a carbon fiber spar, which is going to run through the center of the plane. It's going to provide strength this way. I don't know if you can tell, but like if I bend this corner up and this corner up away from each other, that's going to provide that strength. We're going to embed that in the foam. These are vertical stabilizers, which I should have painted, but FPVHQ is going to send me some vinyl stickers to put on these that are black so that they fit real well. We've got, this is called shock cord. And we're actually going to tie it all the way around the plane because what this will do is prevent the plane from... So the primary place for a wing to break, apparently, is like this. So when you hit nose in and the wings try to fold down like that, that's the primary issue. So what this is going to do is wrap all the way around the wing, and it's going to prevent it from breaking out like that. You have push rods, which connect the servos to the... what's the word I'm looking for? The elevons. Those are pretty straightforward. And some business cards. And the mounting point for your motor and miscellaneous servo mounting gear, which I don't think we're going to do tonight. It's all going to be focused on the foam. So tonight we're focused on getting the fuselage all built and ready to go. And then next week we're going to come back to this build and finish it up with all of the electronics. And then hopefully shortly thereafter I'll upload some, maiden flight videos and all that. It'll be fun. All right. And yes, this is a very small wing, but I think it'll be really fun because it's not going to break and it's going to be fun to just throw it into danger and have fun. All right. So, instructions. Oh, man. Here on the FPV live stream, we're always prepared. All right. So, like I said, this is a kind of bizarre episode. I hope that's okay with you guys. Definitely leave your feedback on the Facebook page and say whether or not, this was worth your while, if it was something different and fun, or if it was just annoying and you don't know what you're doing. I don't know what I'm doing, so. All right, so build notes. To make it a floater, it must be light. Use laminate, but leave off the E-tape. Okay, I don't want it to be a floater. Okay. So, for a fast sport plane, you want your center of gravity to be 5.5 inches back from the nose of the plane. Okay. The spar, which is the carbon fiber piece, is back 5 inches from the nose. The elevon throws at least 1/4 inch up and down. So the throw would be, how the swing of the elevon, how much that has available. Talks about prop size. And battery size, and the fins are necessary. Okay, so you are going to need a low-temperature hot glue gun, which I've got right here. Then we're going to be needing Gorilla Glue. Oh, I left that in the garage. I'll have to grab that in a sec. A metal straight edge. I'm going to use a ruler or a yardstick instead. A soldering iron, which is for later, not for today. Pliers, pen, a razor blade, Phillips head screwdriver, electric drills and bits, and iron for applying laminate. It says that a clothing iron may be used, so today's episode we're going to be doing ironing live on the internet. So that's going to be fun. Velcro straps and all that kind of stuff. Okay, so... So what I've done already before this stream, I'm not going to forget the giveaway. Actually, I'm just going to announce the giveaway on Facebook. So like the page, subscribe, and then come back and I'll announce the giveaway sometime tomorrow. So the first thing that I wanted you to do is to take the EPP pieces and rub them together a whole bunch to get some of the like nastier bits of like fiber off, which I spent some time last night doing, and then I painted it. So the first step, then, is to glue the two halves of the wing together like this, and it just says using regular hot glue at low temperature. So that's what I'm going to do. Oh, also, this kit is available. It is only $75. Like, that blew me away. I mean, you get all of the electronics, the battery, receiver, and the foam for $75. It's pretty good deal. All right, I got to run and grab that glue, and I'll be right back, and then we'll keep going. One sec. Okay, sorry about that, I'm back. All right, I'm going to plug in my hot glue gun and get that heating up. Who here has done fixed wing? Who wants to do fixed wing? And who has no interest in fixed wing? I'm interested to hear what you guys say. Out of 10, best part of the stream when I'm not on camera. That's a jerk move, man. That's a jerk move. Yeah, so in a couple weeks, we're not going to have an episode, unfortunately, because I'm going to go out to New Jersey. Can I say that? Yeah. For the next DRL shoot, so that could be interesting. So I'm excited about that, but it means I'm going to be missing the Thursday night live stream, unfortunately. I need to get some glue. I have a fixed wing built, but still not flown yet. Been way too long. Caliber 37 with APM. Okay, cool. Wings are great for flyers on a budget. No fixed wing, but interested. Cool, that's exactly what I was hoping for, is that there would be some interest in fixed wing, even though maybe not a lot of people have tried it or are super interested in multicopters. Actually, everybody that's here, if you would be so kind and willing, run over to Reddit, and I have made a post announcing that this is live right now. It'd be really helpful for the stream and for the product and future giveaways if you were able to go and upvote that and kind of help us continue to push the boundaries of digital entertainment with first-person view stuff. So, yeah. And you could send me the Karma Court or whatever if you want. But, hey, I appreciate any help you can. I have done some fixed wing. I called the wing the hot glue warrior. Every time it flew, it needed more hot glue. I found that CA works a little bit better. It's real easy to get it to set fast. High staff has dabbled with fixed wing with a Tech Sumo. Quads are my passion, but I like wings a little bit less, so I haven't tried it. If you go to reddit.com/r/multicopter, you'll be able to see it. All right. Hopefully we got enough heat and glue here. So I'm literally just going to lather this. If I can get enough out. Oh, boy. I need a bigger hot glue gun. Most of the rigidity is going to come from the spar and from the laminate and the shock cord. We don't need to be worried about this being perfect, but I want it to be as good as I can. Indoor living room maiden. Yeah. That's a lot of people have asked me that, if I'm going to be maidening this, but I don't think I'm going to be doing that in here. Especially because we're not doing the electronics this week. We're going to get to the electronics next week. RC Nova. Hi there, hobbyists. You have come to the right place if you're looking for hobbyists. Although I think there's usually have a couple professionals in here, too. not just hobbyists. So I'm just adding a little bit extra to the seams where they didn't quite fill in, so that everything is nice and solid. Again, I have no idea what I'm doing. Future hobbyists. RC Ninja, are you not flying yet? Better have a big ass living room. Yeah, exactly. That's funny. Ruined it already? How did I ruin it? I don't know what I'm doing. Dang it. I suck. Okay. So we glued the two pieces together. Spar. There's one flat carbon spar included. Lay a straight edge along the center of the wing and place a mark at 5 inches back from the nose from the 5-inch mark. Use a square to measure out 4 inches to either side. Mark the point with your pen. My pen, I made this thing black. I'm not going to be able to see this at all. I'm just going to be on the bottom of the plate, I believe. Yep, bottom. Okay. So I've got a handy-dandy ruler. I'm going to go 5 inches back from the nose, which is here. And then I've got a yardstick, which will be my makeshift square. We'll try with an orange pen, see if this shows up. Oh, a little bit. Come in an inch to here. And in an inch to here. And we'll go here. White paint Sharpie. I wish I had that. All right. Now, you should now have a spar line marked on your plane. Use your straight edge and a new sharp razor blade to cut a slit a half inch deep, enough for the flat carbon spar. Okay, so I put a brand new tip on this today, and so I'm going to now cut a 1/2 inch slot along the length of the plane. Oh, God. Yeah, this is a brand new blade. This is horrible. Oops, didn't go far enough. Alright, so now we're going to take this spar and jam it in here. It looks like we might need to go deeper in some places, if you know what I mean. Ugh, what in the world? This is brand new. Oh, this is a brand new blade. Like, I literally put this on before the stream started. Try a smaller one, I guess. All right. That went a little bit smoother that time. So I'm just looking for the points where it's a little bit higher than it should be. I'm just kind of cutting those out a little bit more and pushing it down at those points. So now I've got that pretty well buried in. So yeah. All right. Glue it in with glue. You can also glue the spar in with Gorilla Glue if you wish. Remember to activate the glue with a small amount of water, then tape over the spar quickly to keep the glue from expanding out. Okay, so this is just thin CA that I bought, labeled as Gorilla Glue. So this should be, it's supposed to cure very quickly. I'm not too worried about it being perfect again because, you know, it's going to be taking a beating. It's going to have all of the other elements to it. Okay. All right. So how long will this thing you put in be useful? How long? Paint stick. Carbon spar keeps the wings stiff. Yeah, it's going to keep it from flexing this way. I'm going to try to get down each side here. Okay. Feel pretty good about that. I'm going to try to just jam this in a little bit more. Maybe that should be all right. Should I like this video? Sure. Yeah, you definitely should. Would it make more sense to make this thing FPV? It will be FPV, just not right away. I'm going to use it to kind of practice a little bit. I'm just going to use a little hot glue to kind of fill in some of these holes that the foam created when I cut it out. I guess for some reason my blade was too dull. I'm just using this to infill it. Okay, what will be next? All right. Let's see if it looks stinky. I'm gonna open up the window, actually. Is it a foam safe CA? I don't know. What is a foam safe CA? Do you use low temp hot glue? You're supposed to. There is no adjustment on this, but it doesn't seem to have affected the foam poorly. Okay, so. You can also glue the spar in with Gorilla Glue, blah, blah, blah. Okay, shock cord. The weakest point of a flying wing is the space between the elevons and the trailing edge. So like I was saying before, that's these spots and right here. In a head-on impact, the weight of the wingtips tears the wing in half from the back forward, so it tries to go. The shock cord ties the trailing edge of the wing together to prevent this damage from occurring. The shock cord can be glued in with baking soda and CA or glue and water. Using a razor blade, cut out a very shallow slit around the entire perimeter of the wing. Okay. Sorry, I'm late. Company is over. How do I kick them out nicely? You say, get out of my house, damn it. Okay, so I'm going to cut a slot around the outside of the entire plane. Hopefully. Super glue seems to be pretty dry already. Once again, I have no idea what I'm doing. Just following the instructions. I think the issue is that I'm having is that the spray paint that I used to do the black is actually making a coating that's making the knife grip on the foam. And that's why we're getting the kind of tearing once in a while with the... Alright, so now there is a slot all the way around the outside of the frame into which I'm going to insert, wherever it went, this shock cord. And what this is going to do is keep the wing from splitting open in a nose-in crash. For this, they said you want to use a flathead screwdriver, which I guess I don't have right here. Actually, what? This guy, yeah, this will work. So now we'll see how bad the cut was. I'm going to turn this a little bit. This is a pain. Actually, one thing that I saw them suggest was to use a tube to try to set it down in there. So I've got this full standoff. Let's see if this works. Nope, that's not helping either. You're going to knot the ends together once you get it all the way around. Yeah, thank you. That was a good note. I remembered that just now. Just having it a hard having a hard time getting it to go in the slot and stay in the slot. And this is even the part I thought was going to be a pain. There we go. Have you ever flown a racing wing before? I have not flown a racing wing. I have a VAS Wraith that is a that has the same or similar characteristics. I'm hoping that this will speed up once I kind of get the technique down. Now we're getting it. I feel like I should, I don't know. Oh, okay, so this is kind of working here. They did it a different way in the video that I watched, but I don't have the right stuff for it. Looks like a boomerang, nice. So what's working is that if I run the flathead kind of down the hole before I try to push it open, I can one, see the hole a little bit better, and then two, it opens it a bit, and that makes it much easier to get it stuck in there. Once I get it lined up with the hole, then I just kind of wedge it in, and it usually sticks pretty good. But yeah, so if I open it up a little bit like that, and then go back and just kind of massage it down in, that's working the best so far. And then always keeping one finger holding it down. Yeah, 10 out of 10, I would not recommend the kind of spray paint that I got. I just picked like the cheapest black matte paint that I could find, and it's like coated, and it's coming off funny, and it's making a big mess on my new mat. This is where it would be nice to have a little bit of music for the stream. But you guys can always just turn on your own music in the background, right? Hey, are there any coupon codes for Multi-Order Mania right now? I do not know the answer to that question. Nor would I answer it because it's not Multi-Order Mania's live stream. It's FPVHQ. And I think FPVHQ has a sale for Independence Day. Ugh, come on, buddy. So, learning number one is make sure you get a real nice clean cut when you're going for this shot chord thing. Because mine has not been, and it's been a pain to work with as a result. ...5% coupon off for today's live stream for anybody who wants to pick up anything. Including this kit for $75, minus 5%. International shipping. Yeah, like I said, I've got a VAS Wraith that I've been flying a little bit. I actually really like flying fixed wing. It's very relaxing compared to mini quads. You can kind of just chill and, you know, enjoy a sunset or, you know, kind of go out a little bit further than you would ever with a mini quad and enjoy, you know, the freedom of flight more than the acrobatics of it, which, you know, are also awesome, but it's a different kind of thing. We're almost there, guys. Okay. The 5% off is coming. He hasn't yet posted it. Okay. We have run the shot cord all the way through. Let me grab a pair of scissors, actually. Which are just right here. Paul, you ever flown the tiny loop? I have flown one, yes. Okay, so now the goal is to get this fairly tight without pulling it out the back. Because what you don't want is to have, you want this to be as tight as you can get it without accidentally causing problems. So I'm just going to use this to help me get a grip on it. Okay, that's about as tight as it wants to go. And it came out the back. Frick. All right, there we go. Now it's stayed. So I'm just going to tie this down. Sorry, if this isn't on camera, it's kind of hard to do leaning over. So I'm just going to put a simple knot in it. Okay, and then I'm going to cut these extra bits off. Okay, so now there's a string all the way around, and what that's gonna do for us is that in a nose-in crash, it's gonna prevent the whole thing from splitting in the middle. Because what it's doing is it's providing strength. So you know, if you hit the middle, these pieces are still going to want to keep going. So you're preventing it from splitting open this way, you know, like a wishbone. So the string, by being there, is spreading this the impact from this section out across the entire wing, and that's going to keep it from splitting in half in a nose-in impact, which is the most likely kind of impact. So now what we're going to do is we're going to run CA along this entire gap. We'll start with this section because it's the most tricky. Pop out just a little bit. I'm gonna let that set before I get too far. Paul, do you recommend the Apollo 2 for indoors? Not inside the house. Butter with a 1306 on 4,000 kV. Oh, you do the 4,000 kV? But that's, you got a warehouse. So you got a lot of space to work with in there. I would not fly something 3-inch inside the house. Especially not on 4S. Because it's just heavy enough that it could pretty easily, you know, break a belonging or a lamp or go through a window, etc. And that just wouldn't be good. So like I said, I'm just gluing the shock cord in. Alright, I'll let that sit for a second again. What about the RS-90? I have not flown the RS-90 much. It's got the wrong size lens, I can barely fly it. Damn, I didn't see the sound warning. Rest in peace. That sucks, I'm sorry, dude. I keep the super glue off the mat here. Just letting this dry a little bit more. Still getting there. Yeah, but this thing is a lot stiffer now with that carbon rod in there, especially. It's crazy, actually. Okay, all right. Well, that's drying. Let's figure out what our next step is. Okay. If there's too much glue, it will expand and spill out of the slit. This is normal. After it's dry, use a razor blade to shave off the excess glue. Formica motor mount plate. Formica is thinner and stronger than plywood, is much lighter than a metal motor mount. Glue the Formica plates to form the foam triangle block as shown. The Formica plate should be perpendicular with the wing. The plate should hang over the bottom edge so it rests against the back. Okay, where's the wedge? So we got the wedge. So the idea is going to go on top. Yeah, that's pretty straightforward. Michael, does this, so I noticed that the motor has standard multi-copter motor mounts. Is it possible, once I glue this on, to be able to mount the motor still? Because what will happen is that I'll have to, because the motor is going to go on this way. So how do I get, how will I be able to get it on if I glue it all now? Scotch Tape Extreme will stick to EPP without a spray adhesive. It is lighter than many other reinforced tapes, and it can hold up to 320 pounds of weight per inch. It is available at many office supply, hardware, and postage stores. Extreme tape needs to be covered with laminate, or it will yellow and dry and come off in UV sunlight. The tape needs to be tight without wrinkles for maximum strength. This tape adds weight, so be careful on how you use it. Okay. Just mounted the motor, then glued it on. You just glued the motor straight to it? Or you mounted the motor to this thing and then glued it? Okay. Okay, so we're literally going to glue the motor straight to the Formica. We're not going to, like, screw it in or anything. Or am I drilling holes, mounting this, and then gluing the whole assembly on? I'm just looking for what Michael suggests. Drills and holes? All right. Let me grab some drill bits, I guess.
I think I need to. Okay, I'll be back. Hold on.
Google brushless motor mode. All right. Okay. It's a little too big. I'm short on drill bits because they keep freaking breaking on me. Cheaped out on them, and now they're biting back. Oh, I've got washers here if I need them, I guess. Yeah, we'll be fine. Okay. So what I'm going to do is put the motor on there. I need a hole right in the middle, so let's start with that. Let's make that a little bigger. All right. Now, got one of these things from a different kit that I can use to designate. So I made a little X on the piece, and now I'm trying to just lay it down and mark the holes. Oh, it didn't draw at all. Jeez. Let's try that again. Start with that. Why would it not come pre-drilled? I don't know, that's a good question. Okay. Now, with any luck, these will line up all right. Close enough. I suppose it probably doesn't matter too much if we're touching windings here, does it? I'm not going to worry about that third. Okay. So, motor's mounted blue plate. Nice and solid, not going anywhere. So now we can just glue it right to this underhanging, basically. Probably being careful not to put any glue on the motor. I suppose we'll just go with the hot glue again for that. Or do you think they wanted it to be CA'd? I don't know. How about a little both? It's a nice little motor. I like these. Kind of want some more. Still eating up. Am I even putting this on yet? No, I guess I am. Not until after the tape, it looks like. Because we'll want it on to be checking propeller lengths and stuff. Paul is starting to sound healthy, yeah. It's been a long time coming. Jeez, I was so sick for so long. Finally not coughing anymore, like today or yesterday, I think. It's crazy. So we're down on viewership right now. Is this pretty boring? Is this, what are you guys thinking about this so far? Still not hot enough. Leave a little extra bit hanging below the wedge so it hits the wing. Yeah, oh yeah. Yeah, I got that. Mine, it's gonna look like that, right? So I got this piece down here that's gonna overlap with the wing. Coupon code Boba Fett's beard. I love it. Guys, give old Paul a thumbs up for doing this. Yeah, for looking like an idiot on air for all of you to figure out how not to build an FPV wing. I wouldn't say I'm converting. I'm definitely trying it out. Congrats on your win at Riggs. I hope I did good on the video. Yeah, good. No, it was great. Did you see it?
Hey, Rachel.
My wife is outside the window, pulling an atom, as it were. All right, so is it okay if I go ahead and glue this right on then? Or do I want... I guess I want to do the tape first, it looks like. All right. I have the volume turned up so I can hear throughout the first floor of the house. That's hilarious. I love it. Okay. Is this your first wing? Yes. How did the wife like you winning some cash at the race? She loves it. She took it all. No, I'm just kidding. Okay. So that's going to end up going on like that. So Does this tilt up a little bit so it pushes the nose up on purpose? Is that a thing? Because that's what it looks like it has to do. Okay, so on the bottom, the first set of tape will form an X over the Formica plate on the bottom of the wing and directly above it on the... It's not showing that step very clearly. Wait. The first set of tape will form an X over the formica plate on the bottom of the wing and directly above it on top of the wing to help the shot cord. The elevons will add more strength and I think what that's saying is I need to go a piece from here to I don't know where to. They show the pattern, but it's not very clear what they're showing. How far down does it go? Like to here or so? So I think it's like that, but we also need a 1-inch strip, which I don't know if I have a good surface to. That didn't work. Look at page 1 of the instructions.
Oh boy.
Oh. Page 1. Okay, yeah. That's my bad. Let's try this one more time. That actually worked pretty well. Okay, so that's gonna look so ugly. I knew it. All right, and now we're gonna go the other way. Try to keep that as uniform as possible. That med is sweet. I want one. Yes, it is sweet. Okay. Now we're going to do the same thing on the top, but I guess we could just finish the bottom first. So now we're going to put consecutive lines of tape down through. Get rid of that. Every time before your stream, I have to take a nap. I guess I'm glad you're not taking a nap during the stream. I may or may not have just napped during the stream. That's hilarious. Okay, there's that. So now we're going to flip it over, and we're going to do that same X pattern across the top, ruining our beautiful paint job, but you know what, whatever. Yeah, we got a ways to go, guys. I'm sorry. I knew it was going to take a long time. And I planned for that by having two episodes, but it's like we might almost do a third episode for the friggin' lamination. We'll do some ironing tonight. If I don't do it all, I'll just kind of finish it off camera. Okay, and now there's one more piece that needs to go across the nose, I guess. I think I'm gonna do and then we need to run some down the entire length of the wing. Thank you. There you go. That's one. Now I got to do the other side. It's actually starting to feel pretty dang sturdy now. Not that I was ever skeptical of that, but it's nice to feel it coming together, kind of. Bam! Look at that. I'm actually pretty pumped about that. Like, it's pretty sturdy. Like, I mean, I'm giving that a good bit of. It's definitely pretty flimsy out here where the carbon fiber spar ends, but I think that'll be okay until the laminate is on. Whew! We're making progress. Making progress. Choosing your propeller. We've already chosen our propellers. Two elevons. You can move up and down like an elevator. And opposite for aileron function or roll. EPP elevons will feel floppy until they are laminated and hinged on the wing. This flexibility keeps them from breaking in an impact. They are more durable than balsa elevons. Before cutting your elevons, you must determine which size of propeller you'll be using and leave space for clearance. The elevons have a top and bottom. Make sure that the point is at the top of the elevon is up, and that you make right and left elevon. Lay the elevons next to the trailing edge of the wing with the right side up, thick side towards the wing. The point of the slanted cut to the elevon should be on top of the elevon. Okay, so what that's saying is put this here and grab our elevons, and we want the point to be pointing in at the top of it, roughly like so. Make sure that the point is at the top. Oh wait, I got this upside down. This needs to be this way. Then this needs to be this way. Okay. The elevons on the top and bottom, make sure that the point, okay, this is the point, is at the top of the elevon. Okay. We're good. All right, I'm going to grab some craps. So we're using a 4-inch prop, it looks like. So we need to make sure that we've got clearance here. I wonder if I should leave clearance for 5-inch. Make sure that those are an even distance apart. So we've got two and a quarter and two and a quarter. Five by four is way more mellow, so I should leave room for five, you're saying? Give yourself enough room for five, okay, all right. So I need a 5-inch prop. Look, here's one. Something like that should be good. So we need, let's call it 3.5. That'll be plenty right there. Now, oops, did I just bump that? No, that's fine. Okay. All right, so I'm going to start with the outside edge because I feel more confident with that. Three and a half. All they want you to do is just take a pair of scissors and just lop it off. Oh my god! That's terrifying. And then make this a straight. Like that. That's all there is to it. There's plenty. I added some clearance. There's plenty there. Half is right there. Let's move it. I'm really starting to get pumped about this thing. Thank you. Look at that action. 3.5. 3.5. Look at that. I mean, there's plenty of clearance. I added a bunch. It's got, you know, there's a easily a 1/2 inch, 3/4 inch on each side for a 5 inch prop. Okay, Elevon's cut. All right, now we're on to the lamination. Okay, laminating the wing. Put one layer of laminate over the entire surface of the wing. Cut lengths of laminate that will cover each wing. Make sure the pieces will completely overlap by about 2 inches in the center of the wing. Fold the laminate over the wing with the rough side of the laminate towards the thumb, making sure it covers the entire top and bottom, overlapping the center. Iron the laminate down by working from the middle to the edges, using short strokes to keep wrinkles out as much as possible. Make sure to wrap around the seal the edges of the wing, repeat the other side of the wing. Okay, so it says 2 individual pieces. Ugh. So the laminate. Did he just use the distance between 2 blades in a 3-blade prop? No, yes I did, but I added extra room for it. It's fine. We grab a real 5-inch prop together.
Complain about it more.
Here's a 50-30. Here's where the elephants are. Jeez. So a 1/2 inch on either side. Easy. Okay, are we happy now? I can hardly see that. Plenty of space. Okay, all right. Laminating. Okay, so this laminate comes with the wing. There's 2 sides to it, which I did not know before now. There's a rough side and a smooth side. The rough side has an adhesive. So you want to make sure that the rough side is the side that's down. And they give you plenty of it, so don't be afraid to just kind of go ham. So they say overlap a little bit in the center. And then we're just going to kind of cut an outline around what we're doing here. And let it overlap to the other side, because this stuff creates a seamless joint. Is it a good idea to laminate a flight test speed build kit? Yeah, that would be a great idea. It would add a lot of strength to your model, that's for sure. That's kind of the only reason I've avoided it so far. It's because I'm worried that it's just going to break after I've put hours into it. I don't really want to. I'd rather be out flying. I don't want to spend a bunch of hours building a plane all the time. What's the purpose of laminating? It adds strength and it provides a ultraviolet block against the tape coming undone. So the tape will burn in the sun, essentially. So I'm making some relief cuts here. We'll add more as we go on. And aerodynamics are key as well. And durability Yeah, sorry. I should have started with durability, probably. So I just have a regular clothes iron. They said would work at Crash Test Hobby. And they want you to start in the middle and move out with short strokes to prevent any kind of wrinkling. Once again, I have no idea what I'm doing. I'm just kind of guessing. I have this at a fairly low heat, as per their recommendation. Whether or not it's low enough, I don't know. We'll find out. Stuck. Don't use the steam option. Yeah, thank you. So it seems pretty good so far. I mean, I don't have any way of judging whether or not that's the case, but... Okay. A heat gun would work. I heard that it doesn't. Alright, so I've got to make some relief cuts so that I can wrap it. And figure out exactly where to do those. Okay, that should work pretty well. Now I'm just predicting where I'm gonna need to make folds. I'm just cutting them out. There's not really any science to this, I'm just kind of guessing. Alright, so I'm going to try to get the leading edge here as smooth as I can. Without burning myself. Thank you to my wife for graciously letting me use her iron. Absolutely gonna burn myself by the time the night is over. Oh, the irony. Jeez, double O, that's bad. That would be pretty ironic if I burnt myself on the stream doing this. Yeah, so I'm just struggling to find a good way to make a seam around the edge here. What camera should I send for the RS90? I order it right now. That lens for my Pico cam hasn't been in stock for months. The kit come with extreme tape? No, it did not. I just went to Home Depot, got it, back in their like tiling section or something. It was not with the rest of the tape. It was like $5. It wasn't bad at all. Double O, ping Pizzy and ask him what micro cam he uses. That'll be the one that we want, or that you'll want. Alright, so I'd say that looks pretty okay for my first time laminating anything ever. I would use it if it had a better camera. Double O. Cool.
Cool, cool, cool.
Alright, so now we gotta do the other side. Okay, I might have to just get some waste here and save it in case there's I guess that'll work. Put it in there for you. Ugh, that is not a thing, but let's just turn that around. Use that one. When will the giveaway be happening? Like I said before, I will announce the giveaway on Facebook. Trying to use the Facebook account as a place to be able to give announcements, to talk about giveaways, to talk about other vendors, and you know, like make a post if I know I'm going to be missing an episode or something like that, just so you guys are able to stay up to date. So I kind of apologize that I have to push it right now, but once it starts to kind of get a life of its own, then I will have to talk about it less, is the goal. So as much of a pain this kind of is, it's actually extremely satisfying. Like, it's like shoveling the driveway satisfying. Just, you know, you can feel it go on and stay on and be good. It's kind of a nice feeling. So I was kind of worried that working with the big iron is going to be a pain. It's actually been pretty smooth. Smooth sailing. Trying to get this leading edge as good as possible, because that's obviously going to be the thing doing most of the cutting through the air. Watch out for any warping on the wings from too much pressure. Nah, it's looking great still. It's all nice and straight. I thought about even doing this episode in the garage because I might need more room. Isn't the stick on the laminate just as good? Isn't the stick on laminate just as good? I do not know the answer to that question. I'm guessing this forms better. Probably is more durable in the long run. Those are just guesses, but that's what it would seem to be. No, I just need a bit bigger desk pole. That's in the pipeline right now, actually, is upgrading my desk situation. To go back upstairs to the office where I originally was and redo that with some more bench space, because this has gotten bigger than I ever thought it would, so might as well create a space dedicated for it rather than taking over part of the rest of the house. Oh no. I hate this thing. I'm just trying to find an attractive way to do the end here. I was not happy with it on the other side, so. All right, look at that. Top side's done. That'll be pretty sweet. Yeah, the green is definitely looking pretty good now that it's covered, like he was saying. And then the elevons are also green, obviously. So once we get those all laminated up, it's going to look pretty freaking sweet. You know, not the most exciting coloring in the world, but it'll look good for sure. Well, I think I'm going to go ahead and call it for tonight. I'm going to go ahead and finish the laminating off screen, off camera here over the next few days. Oops. And that way you don't have to see, you know, you don't have to watch me struggling with lamination for, you know, another couple hours. So I'll get everything laminated. I will finish the underside of the plane, and I will laminate the elevons, and then next week we will install the elevons and then install the electronics as well. That way, you know, we'll have split this up pretty well. We'll have together learned about lamination and about how the shock cord works and how the design of the wing is, and then from there on out we will be able to finish it up, put the electronics in, get it all wired up, and then shortly thereafter I'll be able to maintain it and kind of report back how much fun it was. So yeah, I'm looking forward to being able to get this out and trying it out in real life and fun stuff. So I will announce the winner of the giveaway tomorrow. If you didn't catch it at the beginning, go over to Facebook, to the FPV Livestream page, and post the color of Gorilla Quads mat that you want, and we will I'll have them send it out to whoever wins that. And then, yeah, so, but thanks again to FPVHQ for providing the kit for this. I think this is going to be an awesome little plane. It's definitely a great deal at $75 to get everything. So go ahead and support the FPV live stream and him by clicking that link down there and buying it. So thanks again everybody for stopping by tonight, and have an awesome holiday weekend for those of you in the United States. Anyway, have an awesome night. Come back next week for part two. It's going to be at the same time on Thursday of next week, and we'll get this finished. So, all right. Thank you very much. Have a great night, and stay